So hello everyone, welcome back to our part 4 of current affairs series. So here we are back again with 10 most important current affairs questions. Apart from that, we have also uploaded GK questions video in which we have also given 10 most important questions on GK. Let's start this current affairs series. So we are going to question number 1, which is, as of 12 December 2021, what is the updated ICE UCN status of Finn's Weaver? Your options are endangered, number 2 is vulnerable, number 3 is near threatened, number 4 is least concern. So let's see the answer. So your answer is endangered. Finn's Weaver, Plotius meager Hinchers bird, has been uplisted to the endangered category in the International Union for Conservation or Nature's IUCN Red List key. Highlight: in India, Finn's Weaver numbering less than 500 was listed as vulnerable in the IUCN list. About Finn's Weaver, it is also known as yellow weaver. It is a yellow weaver bird species found in the Ganges and Brahmaputra valleys in India and Nepal. Its two races are Salimali from the eastern Terai and the nominate from the Kuman area. Question number 2. On December 12, 2021, which country signed an air bubble agreement with India? And your options are number 1, Russia, number 2, Australia, number 3, United States of America, number 4, Japan. And the answer is Australia. According to the news published in the Live Mint on December 12, 2021, the India government has signed an air bubble agreement with Australia. All eligible passengers will be allowed to travel between the two countries about air bubble mechanism. It is a bilateral air bubble mechanism under which countries restart flights while keeping some conditions during the COVID-19 pandemic. India has suspended all the international flights operation until January 31st, 2022. Therefore, dedicated cargo flights continue to operate under the air bubble agreement. Question number 3. Which country has been invited as the chief guest for Republic Day 2022 celebrations in India? And your options are Tajikistan, option 2, Uzbekistan, option 3, Kyrgyzstan, option 4, all of the above. And your answer is all of the above. According to the news published in the Hindustan Times on 13th December 2021, India has invited 5 Central Asian countries, namely Tajikistan, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Turkmenistan and Uzbekistan as the chief guest for the 22nd Republic Day celebrations. Key highlight: this is the first time delegates from the 5 Central Asian countries have been invited to the Republic Day celebration. India shares cultural, historical and civilizational links with these countries. Their presence at Republic Day celebration will help to strengthen the relationship between the two sides. Question number 4. In which state is the Buxar Tiger Reserve located recently seen in the news? And your options are West Bengal, Odisha, Assam, Sikkim. And the answer is West Bengal. Buxar Tiger Reserve is located in the Alipurduar district of West Bengal. It shares its international border with Bhutan. Why in the news? According to the news published in India Express on December 13, 2021, the proliferation of dense jungle and big cats habitat attracted the Royal Bengal Tiger. It has happened after 23 years that a tiger has appeared in the Buxar Tiger Reserve. Key highlights: the Forest Department shared a picture of the tiger seen at the East Damanpur Range of the Tiger Reserve. Forest official estimated that a sustainable habitat as the tiger reserve might attract more tigers which had migrated to Bhutan. Question number 5. Which country has collaborated with the United States to fund the construction of an undersea cable in the Pacific? And the options are India, China, Australia, South Korea. And the answer is South Korea. According to the news published in VOA News on 11 December 2021, the United States, Japan, and Australia, also referred to as the Western Allies, will jointly fund the construction of an undersea cable in the Pacific. Significance of the move: it is being done to increase internet access in three small Pacific countries. The three Western Allies will upgrade the cable to provide faster internet access in Nauru, Kiribati, and the Federated States of Micronesia. This service will support economic growth. It will help in improving living standards. Question number 6. G7 has sought to present a united front against Daesh aggression towards, and your options are Ukraine, Chinese, Russian, Indian, Australian. And your answer is Russian. The G7 sought to establish a united front against the Russian aggression against Ukraine. Key highlights: the decision was taken at the recent G7 summit attended by US Secretary of State Antony Blinken and his colleagues from France, Italy, Germany, Japan, and Canada. The decision comes amid international concern that Russia may invade Ukraine. Russia, however, denies any plan to attack. What is the problem? Ukraine is in a crisis in the East-Western relations as it blames Russia for gathering thousands of troops in preparation for a major military battle. In contrast, Russia accuses the United States and Ukraine for misconduct. Question number 7. Which statement is false concerning the Foreigners Tribunal? And your options are: it is a quasi-judicial body established as a Foreigners Tribunal Order 1964. Option number 2. It can determine if a person staying without the law is a foreigner or not. Option number 3. Both option 1 and 2. Option number 4. None of the above. And the answer is both 1 and 2. Foreigners Tribunal Chan, quasi-judicial body established according to the Foreigners Act 1946 and the Foreigners Tribunal Order 1984. Key point: the Foreigner Tribunal can determine if a person staying illicit is a foreigner or not. Under the Foreigner Act 1946 and Foreigners Tribunal Order 1964, only Foreigners Tribunals are empowered to declare a person as a foreigner. Why in the news? According to the news published in The Hindu on 11 December 2021, the Guwahati High Court has found three Foreigners Tribunal order erratic. Question number 8. Which state government has constituted Samanya Varg Ayog to address grievance of the general category? And your options are Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Uttar Pradesh, Himachal Pradesh. Your answer is Himachal Pradesh. On 10th December 2021, Himachal Pradesh Chief Minister Jairam Thakur announced the formation of a commission named Samanya Varg Ayog to address grievance of the general category. About the commission, the constitution and terms of reference for this Ayog will be released in a few days. The commission was established in response to a general category's long-standing desire for a body to address their issues. Similar commission in other states. Similar commissions have been established in Madhya Pradesh and Bihar. The commission formed in Bihar was abolished and the one set up in Madhya Pradesh is still functional. Question number 9. On 12 December 2021, who won the Formula 1 World Championship at the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix? And your options are Nicholas Latifi, option number 2, Lewis Hamilton, option number 3, Max Verstappen, option number 4, Valtteri Bottas. एंड योर आंसर इज मैक्स वर्स्टैपेन. मैक्स वर्स्टैपेन वन द फॉर्मूला वन वर्ल्ड चैंपियनशिप एट द अबू धाबी ग्रैंड प्रिक्स. He became the first Dutch driver to win the Formula One championship with this win. He left behind Lewis Hamilton in the finale. About Max Verstappen under the Dutch flag, Maximilian Verstappen is a Belgian-Dutch racer currently competing in Formula One and Red Bull Racing. He has become the 34th Formula One World Driver Champion. The 2021 FIA Formula One World Championship, it was a motor racing championship for Formula One cars, the 72nd running of the Formula One World Championship. Question number 10. On 12 December 2021, who won the Miss Universe 2021 title? And your options are number 1. Harna Sandhu, number 2. Nadia Ferreira, option 3. Lalila Maswane, option 4. Manasa Varanasi. And your answer is Harna Sandhu. On 12 December 2021, Harna Sandhu from India won the new Miss Universe 2021 title. Key highlight, it was the 70th Miss Universe 2021 conducted in Eilat, Israel. Harna Sandhu, a 21-year-old girl from Punjab, represented India. She won the Miss Universe crown defeating Laila Maswane, South Africa, and Nadia Ferreira, Paraguay. About Miss Universe, it is the annual international beauty pageant. The United States-based Miss Universe organization conducts it.